Welcome back to Ginger Sadie's Crafts. I'm Mercedes. If you enjoy quick and easy craft in DIY projects, clearance finds, thrift store flips, and some rescue dogs, then you're in the right place. So today I have a new video that I'm going to start doing for you guys that I'm going to call Saturday Showcase, where I showcase a craft project that I saw either on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, or Pinterest. And of course, give credit where credit is due. So today's two projects are from, the first one is from Mother Time. I will link her YouTube channel in the description box below. The second I found off of a Dollar Tree DIY page on Facebook. I'll insert a screenshot of the crafter whose project we'll do for our second one. I hope you enjoy them. They're super easy. They don't have to be holiday related. They could be just for fun. Actually, they could be really cute farmhouse decor if you're into that. So I hope you enjoy it. And as I mentioned, it's for everybody. So it's not just holidays. If it's not holidays that you do around your house, don't worry. I gotcha. Anyway, a list of the items needed will be in the description box below. If you enjoy this video, I'd really appreciate it if you give it a thumbs up. It's completely free. It helps me out. And if you haven't already, smash that subscribe button. Come join my family. You know you want to. We have a lot of fun here. We have a good time. It's always great. Totally keeping it real. So everybody can hopefully feel welcome and let you guys know that I appreciate each and every one of you who have subscribed and joined my channel so far and that have been with me from the beginning. I'm really glad you guys are here. Anyway, without further ado, let's get started. All right, for our first project from Mother Time, and we will be using one of these Dollar Tree 4x4 picture frames. Either the garland or the wired garland ties. You can use scrapbooking paper, or you can also use the peel and stick wallpaper from the Dollar Tree. You'll need some ribbon of your choice. You can go farmhouse and do black and white buffalo check. You could do traditional like black and red for the holidays. You can also do some burlap ribbon or some berries. Optional will be, I'm going to be using some buttons, but you can get buttons at the Dollar Tree as well. You'll also need scissors, a pencil, a glue stick, and your glue gun. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our picture frame and remove the backing. And you can keep the glass or not. It really is up to you. But I'm going to take my scrapbooking paper here. And I'm going to trace the paper to fit into the frame. And then cut it out. Now you can either attach this directly to the glass or you can attach it to the cardboard piece. I actually have a little bit of a line here that I don't like, so I'm going to readjust here and cut it so it's more even. So I'm going to move further up on my paper. So if you don't like it, there's nothing that says you can't cut it again and make it to where you like it. Try this again. If at first you don't succeed, try again. And then I'll use my trusty glue stick here. And I'm gonna just glue it directly on to the cardboard piece of the picture frame. If you want to have it a little bit more sturdy, you can always put in an additional piece of cardboard Or like I said, you can also just glue it directly to the glass. And then we're going to take some of our greenery here and kind of make it into a wreath. Actually, I don't like how that one looks. I'm going to use the green ties here because I think they're a little bit thinner for what I would like to use. But there's nothing that says you can't use a bigger picture frame and do this in a bigger version if you like. Here we go. So I have my little wreath here I'm going to make to fit within the frame. And I have some extra piece here, so I'm going to use my scissors to theoretically, yep, there you go, it cuts pretty easy there. And I'm going to do the top, the gap at the top because that's where I'm going to put my ribbon. So I'm going to take my glue stick, my glue gun, and let's see, we're going to glue this on here. Put some glue down. And if you want to use, where's my trusty spatula, guys? Oh, there it is. My trusty spatula here to push down so I don't burn myself, because that, as I mentioned, is not a good time. And then you can, like I said, you can make it Christmassy. You can use some holiday ribbon, but I'm actually just going to use this Buffalo Check ribbon here to make a bow. Is anybody still in the farmhouse, or is that kind of faded for most people? I think it's kind of cute. My house is like an eclectic mix of stuff. I have stuff from when we traveled overseas. I have stuff from just growing up. I have a lot of thrift store finds, yard sale finds, all that kind of fun stuff. So just kind of get your bow to where you want it to be. All know Mercedes struggles with bows. So I'm going to do my little glue here for my bow. And then use my trusty spatula to get my bow down. And you can do your tails as long or as short as you like. Now, this part is completely optional. You don't have to do this, but I think it would be super cute to have like a little button on my bow. That's what Mother Time did with hers. So I'm looking for a little, there we go. That would be adorable. My little button here. Drop the glue gun. I don't want to start a fire that way. Oh no! Oh no! Button fell off. I lost my button. There we go. Look at that. How adorable is that? You can also take apart these little berries too if you wanted. And add little berries on it if you wanted more of a holiday-themed little wreath. But I think that is absolutely adorable. I hope you guys do too. For our second project that I saw on Facebook, we're going to need the metal tags, some alphabet stickers. These ones are from the Dollar Tree, but you can also find smaller alphabet stickers. Optional is some ribbon of your choice. And then if you want, you can also use a button. So what I did here is I started by putting the O in the middle for joy, so that way it's kind of evenly spaced. And then I'm just going to take these alphabet stickers. Place here. Now this would be really cute. You could put it on like some beads, like a beaded garland, but I'm going to take my ribbon, and you can use either like buffalo check, you can use like the black and red, you can use whatever you want, or you don't have to use any at all. So I'm going to attempt to make a bow. Because we all know that me and bows have problems. Get my glue gun here and put a dollop of glue down, and then place my bow. And then if you want to use your trusty makeup spatula to make sure you don't burn yourself, that might be a good idea. So you can leave it as it is, or if you want to add a button to it, I think that would be super cute. So I'm going to look through my little button stash that I have going on here. They sell buttons at the Dollar Tree too, guys. Or you could just raid your own. Does anybody else have like a jar of random buttons from over the years? I have buttons from everything. I think I have buttons for stuff that I don't even have the outfits or like the sweater or that thing from. But I kept the button because I'm like, hey, use buttons for crafting. Use my trusty spatula here. And then, voila, our cute little... Well, that says more like you, but... We can fix the J and move it over so you definitely see the J for joy. Okay, so I do want to show you. So I did move it over. So if you do make these tags, if you want to have the ribbon, you'll probably just want to go ahead and kind of start working your way from the end towards the top to leave yourself some space so the ribbon doesn't overlap. And then I wanted to mention too, you can spell out other things other than joy. You can, if you have smaller letters, you could do hope. You could do faith, you can do love. You can really do whatever you want to fit for your own personal decor.